everybody, and welcome to the release of the Annual Status of Education Report 2017, Beyond Basics. As many of you already know, this year has been an exciting year for us. And as the rest of the morning unfolds, we hope to share some glimpses of what we have learned over the last year. I'm going to begin with a little bit of an activity. Hopefully you all have some clickers. If you don't, you should have them in a moment. If some of you remember last year, we had done a quick activity with you to take some questions on the status of education, what we know so far from Asar, and what we're thinking ahead. For this year, we thought, you know, how do we begin to ask questions about a new Asar? What is everyone really thinking? What do we know about the youth of this country, and what are some of your thoughts? So we tried to put together a set of questions. We'll do a quick round, see what everybody's thinking. You all must be having a little clicker in your hand. After we're done, you can hand it back to the volunteer who handed them to you to begin with. Please share the clickers, we have a few. So first, let's look back a little bit. So which of these statements characterize the previous 11 editions of Asar? A, citizen-led survey. B, assessment of basic foundational skills, numeracy and literacy. C, a snapshot of performance of India's basic elementary education system. Or all of the above. So go ahead, vote. What is your choice? Which of these statements characterize the previous 11 editions of Asar? Okay, well, that's interesting. At least most of you seem to have a common consensus on what Asar has been doing all these years. So let's move to the next question. What does the phrase going beyond basics most mean to you? A, broadening scope beyond just the education system. B, expanding focus beyond the elementary age group. And C, assessing skills beyond basic numeracy and literacy. There is no correct answer. Oh, interesting. So, assessing skills beyond basic numeracy and literacy. I see a lot of Asar people in the room have the clickers. Well, that's interesting. There's still some of you who think that it means expanding focus beyond the elementary age group. But there's hardly anyone who thinks it's broadening scope beyond just the education system. Hopefully, as we see results today, we'll see what this means to us. We go to the next question. This is my way of checking if you've been seeing all the material outside. Which of these age groups constituting the youth has been the focus of Asar 2017? A, 6 to 14, B, 10 to 15, C, 14 to 18, and D, 18 to 25. Which of these age groups constituting the youth has been the focus of Asar 2017? Okay, fantastic. 7, 9, there are about 10% of you who have no idea what this report is talking about. That's all right. Great. So this year's Asar does focus on the age group of 14 to 18. We'll move to the next question. Roughly what proportion, and this is to test what you guys think, roughly what proportion of 14 to 18 year olds are enrolled in a formal education institution? A, less than 50%. B, 50% to 70%, and C, greater than 75%. This is what proportion of 14 to 18 year olds are enrolled in a formal education institution. Wow. Like no consensus whatsoever. That's interesting. You know, one of the reasons why we're doing this report, as Ulema will tell you, is because we want to know more about this age group. So obviously as the morning progresses, maybe we'll have a better idea of this question. The next question. Approximately what percentage of 14 to 18 year olds are doing vocational courses? A, less than 10%. B, 10 to 20%, C, 20 to 50%, and D, greater than 50%. What percentage of 14 to 18 year olds are doing vocational courses? You're allowed to cheat. You can help your people around you. Okay, less than 10%. So majority of us, well, just about, think that less than 10% of youth are doing vocational courses. We move to the next question. According to you, which is the most pressing need that deserves to be urgently measured and addressed? A, access to education. B, functional skills for work. C, exposure to the 21st century landscape. And D, overall readiness for adult life. Well, that's interesting. Well, at least most of us feel that this age group needs to start getting ready for adult life. What does that actually mean? Hopefully we'll get into some discussion around that later today. That brings me to my last question. Of the following options, which is most likely to be a game changer in addressing the needs and issues of 14 to 18 year olds over the years to come? A, a rights-based policy framework by the government. B, investment and inputs by corporate industry. C, initiative and innovation by civil society. Or D, none of the above. Okay, well, I like that everyone puts it on the government mostly. That's interesting. We know what some of us are thinking. But I think it's beginning to answer some questions like these, which is why we are here today. And to tell you a little bit more about ASSER 2017, I'd like to welcome on stage Director of ASSER Center, Dr. Willima Wadhwa.
Good morning and a very warm welcome to all of you here today. Our partners, our volunteers, ASSER associates, Pratham state teams, and all our friends from here and abroad. Thank you so much for taking the time to be with us here today for the release of ASSER 2017. It is also a time to thank you for being with us for our journey. It was 10 years ago that ASSER Center was formally set up on the 1st of January 2008. So thank you for being with us through all these years. Every year, ASSER looks at the learning levels of 5 to 16 year old children. This year, we have a slightly different ASSER for you. One focusing on 14 to 18 year olds, what we are calling beyond basics. Over the years, one of the criticisms, and there has been many criticisms of ASSER, has been around its flow level tool, that it doesn't tell us about what more children can do, especially those who are able to do the foundational reading and arithmetic tasks in ASSER. Since 2012, we've done a variety of research studies looking at older children. Looking at more advanced academic competencies and transition from middle to secondary schooling. You may have picked up the summaries of some of these reports on your way, and do have a look when you get a chance. But what you can do in a controlled research study environment is often difficult to scale up, and scale up especially in the ASSER architecture. So what you're going to really see today has really come from 2 years of piloting that we've been doing with these Beyond Basics tools. We started by looking at 10 to 18 year olds. And questions which were more academic and pegged to the curriculum. But we soon realized that 10 to 14 year olds are very different from 14 to 18 year olds. And there was absolutely no engagement with young people as soon as you showed them things that look like the textbook. And so we have decided this ASSER is about 14 to 18 year olds. And an assessment which is more functional rather than academic in nature. about 125 million, almost 10% of our population, is in this age group. And one out of every five adolescents in the world lives in India. Enrollment, meanwhile, has been rising. Enrollment in Standard 8 has doubled between 2004 and 14. And this is the first cohort of post-RTE children entitled to 8 years of schooling. Remember, RTE came into effect in 2010 and guaranteed free and compulsory schooling for all children in the age group of 6 to 14 up to grade 8. And with almost universal enrollment and automatic promotion till grade 8, more and more young people are completing elementary education. And many of these young people are the first ones to go to school or complete 8 years of schooling in their families. So their participation and their product and successful participation in society is not only important for themselves, but also important for their families. ASRA 2017 looks at four domains: activity, ability, awareness, and aspirations. What are young people doing? Are they enrolled in school or college? Are they taking a vocational course or some other short skilling course? Are they working? Or maybe doing a variety or a combination of these activities? Can young people apply foundational and reading skills to tasks that they do on a daily basis? These tasks could be things like counting money, managing a budget, figuring out the price of an item on sale. Are they aware of digital and financial instruments? What is their exposure to media? And finally, what are their educational and occupational aspirations? Do they have role models in their lives who can guide them and help them to achieve these aspirations? ASRA 2017 was conducted in 28 districts across 24 states. We are calling it a pilot. We went to 20, and there's a sample of about 1,000 youth per district. So while it is not nationally representative, given its sample of about 30,000 youth and geographical spread, it gives a snapshot of the national situation as well as the variations across the state. These years between 14 and 18 are crucial years in the life of a young person. These are years when transition happens to secondary school. These are years when career paths are chosen. Right to education ends at age 14, and at 18, they are adults able to vote and work. ASRA 2017 is an attempt to shine the spotlight on these years. The domains that we have looked at are one way of doing so, right? But they're certainly not the only way. But our hope is that this year's ASRA will help start a national conversation on the challenges faced by youth and the way forward so that our youth can realize their full potential. We are honored to have many of our partners here today, and it is only fitting that the report be released by them and two young ASRA volunteers, Manju and Bhavna, who are also with us today. Because ASRA was focused on youth this year, we reached out to universities and colleges across the country so that we could involve young people in actually doing the survey. And the response was absolutely unprecedented. And some of these colleges even made participation in ASRA as a part of their curriculum. So we are really looking forward to working with these partners, with our partners in the future, because we think this is a great opportunity to involve young people. So, you know, more young people you involve, the more change you're going to see. To start off with, we have a short film showing you some glimpses from the field and highlighting some youth stories. But before I end, a very, very big thanks to all the ASRA and Pratham teams who have worked so hard to bring this report to you today. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. स्थान है और मैं 17 साल की हूँ और मेरा घर प्रीति में शिमला में।
मेरा नाम विक्रम हस्ता और मेरा उम्र 16 चल रहा है अब।
मेरा नाम सोनू है और मेरी एज 17 ईयर ओल्ड।
నా పేరు సారి గణపతి, నాకు 17 సంవత్సరాలు, నేను ప్రతిభ జూనియర్ కళాశాలలో చదువుతున్నాను।
15 సాల్ కితి తమ్ మేనే స్కూల్ ఛోడా థా, మమ్మీకి కమానే వాళ్ళ కోన్ నీ థా, తో హమ్ కమానే లగే, తో ఇసిలే పడాయి ఇచ్చి లగతీ థీ, ఇసిలే పడాయి కర్తీ థీ, టీచర్ మన్ హోతా థా, కభీ కభీ టీచర్ కో పడాతే హువే దేఖతే థీ, ఇసిలే ముజే మన్ హోతా థా, కభీ కభీ మే భీ టీచర్ బనూ, బేఠే బేఠే ఆరామ్ కర్ బచ్చో కో పడాహూ।
4 బడే సార్ ఫుట్బాల్ ఖేళైవా పై జాఉచి सर, डिफेन्स लाइन चाकरी मोर आशा करी चाकरी करेंगे से सर सबुदिन सका दौड़ा दौड़ी करुँ देशर सुरक्षापाई आशा करूँ। ये चिट्ली गट नरक वाल नीट शात तग्त नक्सीडेंट अंक विपत्त मन के काबी आ विपत्ल जनल जनल रक्षा उद्देश्य मेद नीन इंडियन नेवी आफीसर
तो मैं ये चाहती थी, मेरी जॉब लगेगी ना फौज में, तो मेरे को एक घर ले, 2 रूम ही होना वो भी बहुत है, पर 2 रूम लेने ही है, इसलिए पढ़ाई करो अच्छे से जॉब लगे, बस वही है, और तब घर भी लेना है, अपने मम्मी पापा के लिए कुछ करना है।
मेरे को पुलिस में जाना है, एम है मेरा पुलिस में, ना 6 से लेके एम था उसमें, चलो ये ना अगर वहाँ से लोग डरते भी है उसमें, चलो कुछ किसी में भी लग जाए पर पुलिस में तो जाना ही, पर मैं लग नहीं सकती,
स्कूल में कोई भी गाइड करने के लिए नहीं है, घर वालों का सपोर्ट तो पूरा है पर किसी को इतनी समझ नहीं है कि किस कैसे करना है। एग्ज़ाम का मेरे को नाम नहीं बताया कि क्या नाम होता है, पर ये बोला कि हाँ टफ होता है, अगर वो एग्ज़ाम का नाम बता तो क्लियर हो जाता कि इस एग्ज़ाम का नाम ये होता है।
टीचर बनने के लिए अच्छा पढ़ना होगा, अच्छा पढ़ना जो नया उसका दिमाग में और अच्छे तरह बिठाना, उनको ट्यूशन पे जाना और ऐसे, मुझे नहीं पता ऐसे टीचर बनाने का कॉलेज भी होता है, टीचर बनूँ या नहीं बनूँ तो लाइफ ऐसे ही चलेगी, वैसा चेंज तो नहीं होगी।
डिफेन्स लाइन चाकरी तो मुझे भल कि जाने कौन कौन अच्छी कौन करा जीवो जाहु देखी शुणी मेरे बंधु धरती हमारा डिफेन्स चाकरी से पढ़ने के लिए कॉलेज तो मालूम नहीं, आम कॉलेज से तो किसी कहती ना डिफेन्स लाइन चाकरी विषय मैंने सेमती आसती ना कि कहीं लेक्चर मैडम भी कही ना बड़ बापा आ मो कका जी बुझे मैंने एतकी मार्क दरकार प्लस टू सेकेंड इयर आर आमर तो पढ़ापाई सुविधा ना चेष्टा करें निजे निजे
नावी आफीसर अलगव्वाल प्रिपेर अव्वालनेवी आफीसर अलगव्वाल प्रिपेर अवतना నాకు నావీ ఆఫీసర్ అవ్వాలని అనుకున్న తప్పించి వాటి మీద ఏవి చదివితవుతాయనేసి తెలియదు, ఎక్కువ మంది మ్యాథ్స్ గట్టా చెప్పారు కానీ మరి ఏవి చదివితవుతామనేది నాకు కూడా తెలియదు। మా నాన్నగారు అయితే చదువు వార్తాపత్రికలు చదివి అని చెప్తారు తప్పించి ఆయనకి ఎలా ప్రిపేర్ చేయాలో తెలియదు, ఎందుకంటే అతను ఓల్డ్ మ్యాన్, అతను 5వ తరగతి వరకు చదువుకున్నారు, అంతే మా అమ్మగారు చదువుకోలేదు।
जिंदा रहूंगी तो कहीं बेटी होंगी और क्या
आशा करी आओ एमती कष्ट नष्ट पाइबि भगवान को चांस भी पाइबि आशा तो बहुत अच्छी डिफेन्स लाइन चाकरी करने
नावी आफीसर का लेकिन यदा गवर्नमेंट जॉब पंदपोनते नीन कष्ट तत्व नाबी नीन एक् तक इट समस्या की वनकाड़क दिन पोरा ओडना सर నేను ఏదో ఒకటి సాధిస్తానని నమ్మకం నాలో ఉంది కాబట్టి నేను మా తల్లిదండ్రులు బాగా చూసుకుంటాను।
अगर मैं पुलिस बनूंगी ना तो सब पे इफेक्ट पड़ेगा, सबकी बेटियाँ सोचेगी हम भी ये करें, हम भी जॉब करें, कुछ ना कुछ करें, उम्मीद नहीं छोड़नी है, उम्मीद में तो दुनिया कायम है, तो मेरी उम्मीद भी टूटेगी।